You can find the canal coolant used in the video under the link in the description. Turn your engine off, pull up the handbrake, pull on the bonnet release lever and open the bonnet. You can see the expansion tank to the right of the engine compartment. To facilitate the flow of liquid when draining, open the expansion tank plug. To drain and bleed the coolant on your vehicle, you need to lift your vehicle to gain full access. Lift the front of the vehicle. Place the vehicle on the axle stands. We strongly suggest watching the tutorial, raising your vehicle safely before carrying out this step. If the front plastic crankcase is present, you should now remove it. For complete draining and bleeding of your coolant system, we recommend performing the operation when the engine is cold. Get a collection can for the liquid to collect the coolant when it comes out. As you slide under the vehicle, you can see a coolant hose connected to the radiator. Remove the clamping clip from the hose. Then disconnect the radiator hose. Be careful. When the hose comes off, you can get a free shower. Leave the liquid to flow out for a few minutes. As the radiator hose runs upwards, it is not possible to bleed all the coolant by gravity. To complete draining the circuit, disconnect the hose at the thermostat outlet using clamp pliers. Then push a funnel into the hose, which will allow you to add demineralized water to the radiator and drain the remaining liquid. Reconnect the hose at the thermostat outlet. Reattach the hose to the radiator. Then put the clamping clip back in place. Before adding coolant, we recommend that you thoroughly clean the cooling circuit by filling the circuit with demineralized water through the expansion tank. Press the cooling hoses to force the air present in the circuit back into the expansion tank. Remove the air inlet conduit from the resonator. Then remove the resonator. You can now access the cooling circuit air drain screw. Using a small socket wrench and a 10mm socket, unscrew the air drain screw located on the thermostat. Finish unscrewing by hand, being careful not to drop it. Open the expansion tank plug, which will create a draft and allow air to escape through the bleeder. When water flows continuously from the bleeder, it means the air is no longer present in the cooling circuit. Close the expansion tank plug. You can now screw the drain screw back on. Put the resonator back on. Place the air inlet conduit back. Start your vehicle. Make sure the air conditioning is turned off. Then turn the ventilation and heating to a maximum to circulate water in the cabin heat circuit. You can keep acceleration around 2000 RPM to speed up engine warm-up. Once the engine is at operating temperature, as the engine temperature rises, the thermostat should open. Check that the hose coming out of the thermostat is hot. This means that the thermostat is in open position and fluid is circulating through the engine. You should also check that the cabin heater supply hoses are hot and that warm air is coming out of the vent, which means that fluid is circulating freely in the heater circuit. You can then turn off the ignition and wait an hour for the engine temperature to drop. Once the engine is cold, open the expansion tank plug and repeat the circuit draining operation. This will remove a good portion of the impurities of the circuit. extract the demineralized water from the radiator, disconnect the hose at the thermostat outlet. You can use specific compressed air tools to push out the water remaining in the radiator. Next, insert a funnel into the hose at the thermostat outlet, which will allow you to add coolant to the radiator and drain the remaining demineralized water. Reconnect the hose at the thermostat outlet. Reattach the hose to the radiator. Then put the clamping clip back in place.
All parts used in this tutorial are supplied by our trusted partners. These partners also help us create as many video tutorials as possible. Check them out in the description below.
You can find the canal coolant used in the video under the link in the description. Fill the cooling system with the fluid recommended for your vehicle. You can find a selector under the link in the description of the video. Fill the expansion tank to the maximum level. Press the cooling hoses to force the air present in the circuit back into the expansion tank. You can now repeat the same operations on the drain screw to remove the air from the circuit. Once the air has been pushed out of the circuit, you need to readjust the coolant level in the expansion tank. Close the expansion tank plug. Start your vehicle. Make sure the air conditioning is turned off. Then turn the ventilation and heating to a maximum to circulate water in the cabin heat circuit. You can keep acceleration around 2000 RPM to speed up engine warm-up. Once the engine is at operating temperature, as the engine temperature rises, the thermostat should open. Check that the hose coming out of the thermostat is hot. This means that the thermostat is in open position and fluid is circulating through the engine. You should also check that the cabin heater supply hoses are hot and that warm air is coming out of the vent, which means that fluid is circulating freely in the heater circuit. Turn your engine off. Adjust the expansion tank to maximum level. We recommend checking the general condition of the cooling hoses in case there are any cracks or leaks. You should also check that there are no leaks on the drain screws. You can now put your vehicle back on the ground. During the first few kilometers in your vehicle, pay particular attention to the coolant level, which will need to be readjusted if necessary. You should also check the ground regularly for leaks. Remember to put the air inlet conduit back in place. Operation completed.
Hi, it's Theo from UseTool. I hope this video has helped you a lot in your car maintenance. We would be super grateful if you could spread the word so that we can produce even more tutorials. Simply give us a like, a comment, and hit that subscribe button. It really helps us boost the channel and help the whole community. Thanks a lot and have a great one.